All right, welcome to the demo here. I'm gonna go over my colors. Over here we got burnt umber. This is raw umber, and we have a neutral tint, a little bit of cad yellow light, cad red light, alizarin crimson, actually that's rose madder, yellow ochre, sap green, cobalt blue, cerulean blue, ultramarine blue light. And the paper is Fabriano Artistico. That's the paper I prefer. And I'll use several brushes. This is a Princeton Neptune number 8. This is my half inch dagger. I also have an Alvaro Castanet net needle. And some other brushes I may use. This is a cat's tongue sent to me by ZenArt. I also have a flat by ZenArt. And then I have another smaller dagger right here. So, and in terms of my thought or approach, it's just I have a idea of my composition in mind. I think that's important. You have to have you want to know where you're going. But I don't like to control watercolor so much. It's a medium that I feel will give you a lot to work with on its own. If you allow fusion, gravity, you allow the washes to mingle and you don't get in the way of that stuff, it will actually give you a lot of beautiful accents to work with. And I do think about values. I'm not a color matcher. Okay, I don't like looking at my image and trying to extract colors from it, but I am thinking about values and how that relates to the overall design. So with that being said, I'm going to get rolling here. So I'll start with my larger brush. I don't really have a particular area where I like to start. Sometimes it might be a building, it could be the sea, could be the sky. So I just sort of bounce around, and that gets me from, you know, being in too many ruts. I think it's easy to get stuck sometimes in these ruts when we're painting, and I just don't like that. So again, my approach is to again as much freedom as I possibly can with my work. That's what I'm after there. Okay, I'm not going to tell you guys every single color I'm mixing up here. I went over my colors so you can sort of gauge what I'm doing there, so you can see my palette for the most part. And I'll let you guys fill in the blanks. I do have a lot of teaching tutorials, tons of classes where I go in depth with a lot of stuff. And for those of you that want to get inside my technique a lot more, learn the basics, that sort of thing, you can explore those classes at your convenience. All right, so I got the main structure in there. That's working pretty good. There is a chimney. I don't have the copyright to this piece, so I'm not going to show it on camera. But there is a sort of a chimney going up the side here like that. So a lot of my images, I explore and find them online. So sometimes I have a copyright, other times I don't. All right, so that's looking pretty good. I'm kind of lifting a little bit here and there. I kind of want to put some cars in here later on, so I'm just trying to leave a little bit of room for that. If you're curious about the image, this is an image from Maine, one of my favorite places to visit. Vacation, some gorgeous scenery there, gorgeous coast. And I really can't recommend it enough if you like that rugged coast. And that's sort of, I particularly am interested in Stonington. So beautiful harbor there. Working Harbor, old Maine, you know. For those of you that know anything about Maine, you understand. Not your typical tourist town. That's looking pretty good. I think I'll go ahead and get into the sky here. And again, allowing that stuff to mingle, you know, it's such an important part, I think, of watercolor, and I find I used to get in the way of it all the time. I used to try to control everything about the wash, and I just found that was a losing battle. I felt I was going against the grain a little bit. And that's pretty good. So at this point, I'm going to take a hair dryer to it. All right, that's pretty good. And now I'll give it a little bit of background here. So maybe something like this. And just kind of rough it up. You know, you don't want too much. I don't like to have too much information back there since it's not really a big deal. All right, so now, you know, I've got all these wonderful accidents, and I don't try to exploit every single one because, again, it'll drive me mad sometimes if I do that. But can certainly get in here, you know, pull out a few cars. I do like to change color once in a while. I'm not a color matcher. I think I've mentioned that. If I didn't, I'll say it again. I don't like to try to match nature. I think that's a losing battle. I think it's a very rookie mistake. Again, these are things that are important to me. You may feel different, and that's perfectly fine. That's what being an artist is all about. We all have our opinions and things that work for us, things that don't. And you have to go with the things that work for you. So this is my channel, my video, my painting. So I'm going to just explain some of the things that I like to do. So, and that's one of them. I'm not a color matcher. I also don't try to match everything I see in the image. Again, I use my image for inspiration only. And I make quite a few changes there as I go. And there's points in this, in a painting, where, you know, you gotta concentrate. So if you hear me check out, that's probably what I'm doing. So, and I hit and miss, you know, I don't try to get in and finish something perfectly on the first pass. I just sort of get in there, make a few changes, and then sort of back away from it. Find that works a little bit better, you know, than trying to make everything work at that particular moment. think I can afford a little sidewalk or something here. A little red sidewalk. And I'll just sort of blend that color into a few places there. But yeah, I like to treat each painting as its own little entity, its own little journey. And sort of go with the flow, you know. I don't, some days I'm feeling more confident than others. And things get a little bit looser. And there were times when I get too loose and I gotta dial things back in. And there's times when I'm too tight and I gotta, you know, let it rip. All right, I'm gonna start to introduce a few more darks here, get a little more playful with some texture. Gonna need some information in here. A little door or something there. Negative space painting, that's always a good thing to do. I'll go with a really dark roof here. A few mats on these boats, and then I think I can in the image there are some posts, some verticals. They don't, not exactly telephone poles, but I think this works pretty good. Maybe I can even chisel out some siding, some, you know, another, some more texture there. Might be kind of interesting. I'm gonna get a little color on that roof. Shadow over, and maybe got another sort of shadow coming in from the side there. A little bit too clean in here, so I'm going to lift a little bit here. I like my stuff a little bit rough. I think I'll put one more little vertical in here. And then draw some stuff there. Cast shadow. All right. Hit it with a dryer again. And I'll get some blue jeans there. And we'll put another little figure, maybe. Right beside it here. A bit of skin tone. Looks like we got another little figure right in there. So maybe some shadows, maybe a little hint of a sidewalk action there. I always turn these little dots into birds. Since we're right there on the coast, surely there are some birds. Stronger on that there, and maybe sneak another little boat right in there. All right, hit it with the dryer. Finish it off here with a few highlights. Just a little something there. Maybe a little sparkle in the grass. And that'll do it. So, hope you guys enjoyed it.